previously on 90 Day the Other Way.
This is not a happy walk. I'm only 50% sure that I'm doing the right thing.
Okay, babe, I love you. Scott, don't cry.
Yeah. It's hard seeing her go.
The day Ronald has his bachelor party, and I laid down some rules. No excessive drinking, no strippers. If Ronald doesn't prove to me that I can trust him, there won't be a wedding.
I just left the shop.
How are we gonna pay our rent and our bills? That's terrifying.
And coming up,
I'm worried that I still haven't gotten Ji-hoon's parents' approval to marry their son.
얘기를 일단 제외하고 그냥 우리 둘만의 결혼을.
Venice said to me, "She date American girl." I surprised.
You did go drink at a bar. There was a stripper. You're breaking promises. How do you expect me to say I do?
I want you to write down the card. Siete de diamond.
Cuando me trabajas así, sino que estás trabajando con la magia negra, pues.
I really didn't think it would go so badly.
I did not hear from Aladdin tonight. I hope that Aladdin is there to meet me at the airport. If he knows what's good for him, he'll be there.
What we need to do in order to get married?
For that, you need to send the notice to the bummer at this place.
What a blow. What a blow we just suffered right now.
We love each other. Nobody can keep us apart.
Hola, abuela.
Hola, mijo.
Buen día.
Buenos días.
I just arrived in Ingabao last night, and Evelyn surprised me by telling me that we'd be staying with her grandmother for a few days because the apartment that we'll be staying is having the roof repaired.
I'm really, really happy Corey made the decision to move here. It makes my heart so warm to see him again and be able to hug him and kiss him.
We're going where?
We're looking for a chicken place.
A chicken place?
Yes.
Okay.
It's my brother's birthday tonight, and I like Corey to fit in my family. So I think that it's a good gesture of him to bring the chicken. I'm ready to get the chicken.
This is the store? It's been here? Smells so bad.
Look at the little chicken. Hola.
Hola.
Hola. What is this? Like the chicken factory? What is it, like a farm?
Yeah.
We walk in and I'm like, see all these chickens. I smell this disgusting smell. It's like fermented, rotting death. It's gross. It makes you sick to your stomach immediately.
You, Corey, you pick.
What am I picking?
Chicken.
She's gonna kill it.
Just pick a chicken. That's the chicken we're gonna get. Do you want that one?
They don't have any packaged chicken. You don't have them like a like plastico. I've never had to pick out my own chicken before, and then be responsible for its death and then eat it afterwards. It's just completely wrong in every aspect. I feel like we should go to like a store and buy them. Is there nothing like that we can go to? Like seriously, like this. Whoa, seriously? This is not okay. Like, we're like responsible for this. I'm not even, I feel like I'm sick to my stomach already. I seriously feel sick to my stomach.
But we gotta bring chicken to the
family. I know that.
What should I tell my family then? Oh, there's not enough chicken because Corey chickened out about it. Pásame el cuchillo.
Is this happening right now? Is she actually gonna do this? Oh, hey, hey, whoa. No, hey, whoa, hey, don't, no, please.
What are you doing right now? Come on, be the man.
Yeah.
Oh, what she did? She just cut his neck off. I think
did she
just cut it. Yeah, she did. Yep. That's disgusting. Ugh. Yep. She did it.
So. All right, Corey. Everybody does this here. I don't know why you're creating such a show.
Los hombres de aquí son más valientes que Corey. Es que el chico Corey tuvo una vida privilegiada y tiene que adaptarse a nuestra vida.
Just wasn't expecting that, I guess, you know.
Now that he's back to Ecuador, Corey needs to start getting used to this different kind of life. It's kind of embarrassing me with the people from the town. And now I'm worried that my family might not have a good impression of Corey when they see him for dinner tonight. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, that's fresh. Yeah. Fresh as it gets.
Mm-hmm.
I've been traveling now for 2 days, moving halfway across the world to be with my husband, Aladdin. But I'm feeling uneasy about the way Aladdin's been treating me lately.
A couple days ago, I was blocked on all your social media, and I just want to know that you love me.
A stupid question you ask me now. What I can say? You don't know I love you.
Maybe.
I did not hear from Aladdin tonight. I hope that he's there to meet me at the airport. If he knows what's good for him, he'll be there. I'm excited to finally be in Doha. However, I have a lot of things that I have to work out with Aladdin.
Even closer.
I'm making this huge sacrifice to move to Qatar, because that's easier than it is for Aladdin to move to the US. But I also expect Aladdin to give up a lot and make the same sacrifices for me.
Let's get this party started.
I don't know how things are with myself and Aladdin, but he should be
just behind a couple sliding doors.
Hawa.
When I see Aladdin, he is so happy to see me.
Honey, welcome.
It just makes me feel a lot more relaxed.
Hey, baby.
Wow, those flowers are gorgeous. Wow. Don't get us arrested.
I forget the rules, everything. So I hug her, just I hug and I give her a kiss. And after I remember, I'm in Qatar.
Wow, they're gorgeous. Thank you.
This country, I can't kiss her in the airport. Qatar ilal, you know? But I just don't care, you know? What will happen? They will kick me out. It's okay. Let's go. We are together now. Who are you?
I'm glad to be here. My goodness.
I haven't seen Laura for 6 months now.
Crazy.
Baby. Laura, she look a little bit different.
What?
Do like that.
Yeah.
She gained some weight, you know? So it's okay.
My goodness. Hey!
I am surprised to see that he's brought all of his friends.
Aysam and Majdi.
Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
I really just wanted to have a little bit of time, just the two of us, to go over how he's been treating me, then to kind of force a fake smile. But we are going to talk about this later.
Let's go to the car. I'm happy my friends, they come to see Laura, but now I want to get home and spend some alone time with her. I miss her so much. This is what I feel. I feel I want to do jiggy jiggy very quick.
It's very heavy.
I do have doubts. I still have this thing in the back of my head saying, you can't trust them, you can't trust them. But I'm really here. He's really beside me. So I need to just go for it.
Yay!
Hi.
This is your first Holi, like our first Holi together. And I do have something for us for Holi.
It's been over 2 weeks since I got to India. And today is Holi, and this is amazing. Like, India goes off. I mean, this is a big holiday. I've always wanted to be in India for Holi. And so I'm excited, and I'm ready to go.
Wow. Isn't it pretty?
Yes, it's nice. How do I look?
Yeah, I look good.
I'm so very much excited to show her Holi because Holi is a festival of colors.
When winter ends and spring begins, like first day of spring, it's a day when evil got defeated by good.
And people just forget their grudges and just forgive each other, just hug each other, love each other.
You usually spend this day with your family, right?
Yeah, it's a very big thing for me.
Yeah, because I would like to be able to like celebrate everything with you and your family also.
Today I'm 31 and I never spend my Holi without my family. It's sad.
So are you okay like not being with your family today?
Yeah, actually you can say that a little bit. Like I feel like that, yeah, I miss them on such a big occasion, a Holi. Yeah, but here you and me.
This is another reason why it's important for you to tell your family about me here, because we can't keep living in these lies, you know, hiding and...
This is hard.
I know how this important these... Culturally, yeah. I know how important this is.
And it's a day, like, when we can, as I said, share things and people forgive you.
Yeah. I'm sure we need to be forgiven for many things, yeah. Like hiding our whole relationship from your parents. I feel bad. I'm sad that he's not able to be with his family today, and if he would just tell him about me being here, then we could all be together and enjoy, but when he's ready, it'll happen. So for now, it's just him and I's day to be together and celebrate Holi and have fun.
Like, first we play with our gods, and then we can go ahead and play with our other friends.
Our other friends?
Yeah. Tradition and cultures are a very big deal in India.
I want to make it special for Jenny because this is first Holi here and first Holi for us, like we are together. So, and she is my family too.
Happy Holi!
Oh, happy Holi!
Happy Holi!
Bye bye for you! Bye! Happy Holi!
Happy Holi! Everywhere, wherever you go, like every corner of India or every street, you will find people playing Holi, throwing colors on each other. You can throw color on anybody, but make sure that person is not color allergic with color and all that.
Happy Holi, this is fun. What a fun time.
Wow.
Hi.
Wow. Hello.
Hi.
Wow. Nice to see you guys.
Hello.
Good morning.
Jihoon and his parents are here in Las Vegas to get to know me better. Jihoon and I are really hoping that they will give us their blessing. That way we can get married.
Oh, them say.
But unfortunately, the trip hasn't gone to plan.
클라타클라스.
She's hungry.
드라슬라 이거 좋아. 이거 우리 못 먹을 거. We need to 드라슬라. Got a man.
And then Drusilla got super sick last night. Luckily, my mom was able to fly out and come pick her up and take her back to Utah.
Wow.
I don't like being away from my daughter, but I can't leave Jihoon's parents either.
Let's go.
So today, I'm taking them on a bus tour to get some much-needed bonding time, to have some fun, kind of let loose, and show them the American dream, Las Vegas. I'm hoping Jihoon's parents are going to be impressed because this is my last chance to win them over.
어저거그분수아니야그 famous famous
yes.
water yeah. Wow. Hey, we still casino money. Like a
baby. No, you got it. Ocean's
Eleven. George Clooney, Brad Pitt. Yeah, superstar.
Yeah.
Very nice. Wow. You look, 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 look. 뭔가
아유 한국처럼 그렇게 많이 안 치다.
Are your parents having fun?
Yeah.
I wish Drusilla wasn't sick. I think she would have really liked this. Ask your parents if they think Vegas is different than Korea.
라스베가스하고 한국하고 다른 점이 뭐예요? Different, beautiful building. There are many in Las Vegas.
Yeah, yeah. Do you like America?
Yes, I know. I like.
This is already really different from the beginning of this trip. I feel like we're talking more. Do you like the food? Ask him what food he likes.
음식뭐가 맛있었어요
다맛있어
Everything.
저는케밥만빼고
Except kebab.
Except what?
Kebab.
Yeah.
Kebab. Kebab.
Uh-huh.
Kebab. 대본
Yeah.
If you come to Korea,
yeah.
And I think you will miss your family.
I'm gonna miss my family a lot. I'm worried about Drusilla missing my family too.
Yeah. Drusilla, make Korean friend.
Spending time with Jihoon's parents right now, I feel like they're really warming up to me and we're having a good time and we're actually talking.
Hey, Devon. Look,
yes.
Okay.
Beautiful, 우리.
I really hope that they're going to approve of me marrying their son because my future is on the line.
I love you. Don't worry. It'll be fine. Here comes the food.
Ooh. Whoa!
Chicken roulette.
Big, thank you.
It's the day after Ronald's bachelor party, and last night, he told me everything.
We're at a bar, which I told you I didn't want you to do.
Is that the craziest thing that happened?
How do I say this? The next moment, this woman comes dancing next to me. They seriously got a stripper. And she was dancing all over me and she's like naked and stuff. But what went through my mind all the time is you.
Tiffany.
I just don't want to talk about it. I don't want to, I'm not gonna. I had to compose myself last night, but after having some time to wind down, I'm ready to talk about it today. I didn't say anything right off the bat, but there are some things that really bothered me about your bachelor party. I wanted you to enjoy it, but for you to come home and then tell me you did go drink at a bar, there was a stripper. Imagine what I'm feeling when I learn that you're breaking promises one day out of rehab.
With everything I've been through because of his gambling addiction, trust is our biggest issue. So it just felt like a complete slap in the face since I did tell him exactly what I didn't want to happen, and that's exactly what happened.
Telling you that there's not going to be strippers or bars, I agree it was wrong. But then again, it was just the bachelor's.
To me, it's, okay, you're at a bar. Who's at that bar? Who can come drink with you? Who can maybe just make something click in your head that can go south. And it's not that I'm possessive and crazy. It's literally that you just have made a lot of choices. Mm. And I went through a lot because of that. Mm. And I don't want to go through it anymore. Mm. And that's kind of what bothered me the most. I'm like, did he know any of this? Would he decide, like, would he choose to still lie to me after all this? And then my mind spirals, because that's what it would be like if you were, like, starting to have a relapse, you know? You would lie to me again. You would hide things from me again.
We're supposed to be getting married in 5 days, and Ronald wants me and Daniel to leave everything behind in the United States and come move to South Africa permanently. But I can't commit to that unless I know I can trust him 100%. And Ronald, with this bachelor party, has already let me down so soon after me getting here. I don't know if I could trust him long-term.
I did think all that. I did say, you know, what if he's lying to me? What if he hasn't changed? Those thoughts are always gonna be back there. You know what I mean? Those thoughts until I really fully grow that trust back. And I'm telling you, it's gonna be a full-time job. You gotta really prove to me for a long time and be consistent.
Now, I won't let it happen again. You and Daniel are my life. Building the trust with Tiffany is something that I wish I could get back like that, you know? If I would lose Tiffany, I'll lose everything I have. I'll lose myself, I'll lose my mind, I don't know. Words can't explain what she is worth to me.
You are my number one priority. And what you feel and everything really matters to me, you know?
The trust was really broken, and I'm trying my best to be supportive and not treat you like you're a complete failure, because I feel like I need to give you that chance for us to move forward, right? Mm. But don't mess it up.
I want to trust him, but I can't stop worrying that Ronald might relapse and throw it all away.
Baby, welcome, welcome.
Yay! I just arrived in Qatar, and Aladdin and I are on our way to see our new apartment.
Woohoo! See what my husband rented for us.
I'm just a little bit concerned about cockroaches, because they lived in his old place, so that's a little bit of a concern of mine.
Granny's coming.
My feet are killing me. I want somebody to get me in a wheelchair and just push me.
Welcome home.
Ta-da.
Thank you. Oh. There's an interesting smell to this home. Oh, thank you, sweetheart. You want to give me the big tour? So I know where do I go to the bathroom in here?
It's the bathroom, it's here.
Oh. Okay. Smells like mothballs.
Don't like?
I hate the smell of mothballs. It reminds me of old ladies. Okay, so this is my big stovetop?
What do you want?
This is there. Where's my oven?
The oven is there, this one, the white one.
I feel like I'm camping. Okay, that's not an oven. My oven is like this little round thing that reminds me of what my mother bought me when I was 8 years old. I don't know, I would really like my kitchen to be a little bit better equipped.
I just didn't realize there's no oven, but that's okay.
I think Laura, she just likes to complain, you know, because this is a small apartment. I'm not like a big building for, it's enough, you know? Maybe she's not comfortable with this, but like she need to learn how she live here, you know?
Okay, babe, let's see the bedroom. Get some jiggy jiggy going.
Oh my God, go, go inside, go. Let me take my shoes out.
In the past, when it comes to the jiggy jiggy,
I think it's time we got reacquainted with each other again.
He hasn't been terribly successful in satisfying me and all my needs.
Okay.
Let's leave.
Let's go to bed.
Can you remove the shell, please?
Oh my goodness. Tonight, I hope to take him to unknown territories.
Time for some jiggy jiggy.
Yep.
Yep. Okay. God gave him an older woman for a reason, so I'm going to teach him a few tricks up my sleeve.
How much do they know about me?
You can say Neeraj know a lot about you because he know me like since 2009.
So I've been in India for a few weeks now, and Sumi has finally taken me to go meet his friends.
Hi
Jenny,
nice
Neeraj.
Nice to meet you.
Jenny, my girl.
I'm a bit worried that my friends won't approve of her. I'm really hoping that they will though.
So you are the one.
I'm the one and only one. Yeah, so I'm the one.
Right. How was your traveling?
Long and tiring, but I'm happy to be here. So far, so good. Nothing bad's happened yet.
Okay, and how are you managing yourself?
My mom and dad don't know anything about that. She's here and we are living together. But they already start suspecting that whether I'm working or like why I'm away from home. I want to tell them.
Yeah, he keeps telling me he's going to tell them.
The thing is, I'm a bit scared.
If I tell them the truth about Jenny, I'm worried that what happened last time, that will going to happen again. Because I know they will try their best to stop us. And I don't want this to happen.
Do you want us to come with you when you're going to tell your parents about her?
No, I don't want anybody to come with me. Even.
You don't think so? They could be like, they could save you from being killed.
That's what I was thinking. Jenny took a big step, leaving everything behind, not her children only, her grandchildren as well. Yeah. Sumit should respect her love, and he should talk about Jenny to his parents, yeah, right away.
You guys always have to live your life the way your parents say?
We cannot do what we want. This is the way we are.
I'm trying to have a conversation, but I could hear the table behind us were talking about Jenny, and they were not saying nice words.
The only reason of this drama is the society.
Why care about what other people think, though? You guys need to get past that.
First, we need to know what your mom gonna say about it, what your father gonna say about it. If you don't want to lose her, involve your parents.
Buddy, please don't mind. Please don't mind. You are a good guy. You're making us laugh, but still, request from my side, please. You are bothering us a lot. I keep avoiding that, but you're saying a lot of things she don't understand, but I do understand that, and it's disrespectful.
That guy just turned around and keep looking at us and pointing towards us. He's trying to be a cool guy in front of his friends. But when he start saying something about Jenny, like, look at this corner lady, how much she gonna drink? Then I lose my mind. I will stand up and fight for her every time.
Listen, man. We are trying to show India very good. Where foreigner is coming over here, she's living here, and you're spoiling that everything. You're saying something,
bro, man. Bro, relax, man.
No, I'm relaxing, please. We trying to do something, showing good for India, and you are doing something which is bad for India.
Every time we go out somewhere, people are going to be looking at us and judging us.
And I don't want him getting in fights because of me, because of us together.
Okay, we are sorry. It's fine.
Okay, leave it.
But it's bothering us.
If you don't understand and don't like our relationship, then turn around and enjoy your friends and have your drinks, and that's it. I understand that this is hard for people to understand, but it's unfortunately it's happened, so accept it, and that's it.
Junie.
Oh.
Junie.
Oh,
I got everyone food.
It's lunchtime.
Jihoon and his parents have been in Vegas for nearly a week, and their trip is almost over. I'm worried that I still haven't gotten Jihoon's parents' approval to marry their son. And without the blessing, our marriage is basically doomed.
Pickle. 아이고, 반갑네, 피클 보니까.
I'm nervous to ask, but with them leaving soon, I need to go ahead and find out so I can start planning our big move to South Korea.
My parents are very excited for Las Vegas trip.
We are enjoy traveling, so enjoy.
Tell them I really want to get their blessing. That way we can get married.
그러니까 애기를 일단 제외하고 그냥 우리 둘만의 결혼을 승낙을 하는 건지 아니면 애기 때문에 어쩔 수 없이 결혼을 승낙하는 건지.
Yes, when he said to me he date American girl, she get a baby. I surprised.
I was surprised.
Yeah.
He thought I have a big problem.
You have a big problem.
Yeah, told them.
Ask them, do they approve of the marriage?
Mom, 엄마, 아빠 결혼 승낙하는 거지?
You love truly Jihoon?
Yes, very much.
We welcomes Devon to our family.
Yeah.
We had a good time with you.
I'm glad. We just got Jihoon's parents' approval.
We get married.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell them I was worried that.
아, 엄마 아빠가 드라실 안 좋아할까봐 걱정된다.
No worry. We like 드라실라.
Good.
얘 너무 귀여운 거야. 응, 키스 타임 이러는 거야.
She said most cute number one.
Oh,
the kiss time.
Our family welcomes you to our family.
야, 지금 왜 이렇게 심각 지금 저기 심각한 얘기했어.
아들 회빈이나 단어 왜 이렇게 웃기냐? Family 아니야? Family?
Repeat again.
She say family. Family.
Family. Family.
대본이도 웃잖아.
Family.
I think this is the first time on the vacation where I actually feel comfortable and I feel good. I'm so happy right now.
지훈아 어찌됐든 대본이가 웃는 얼굴 보니까 좋다야.
My mom say you smile face.
Oh, okay.
대본이가 우리 가족이 된다는 게 너무나 좋습니다. 당신도 그렇지?
좋고
The fact that they actually stood up and gave me a hug, which is something they don't do over there, meant a lot to me because it showed that they're actually accepting me into their family.
대본이 안아줘 가서
Now I can finally start preparing to move to South Korea and start getting ready for my new life.
Welcome to my family.
Oh, thank you.
I love you.
Oh, I love you.
Oh,
Hola, hola.
Hola, Cory.
It's Evelyn's brother's birthday today, and we've got to get everything together for that party.
Feliz cumpleaños. ¿Cuántos años?
Trece.
It's been a little over 7 months since I've seen Evelyn's family, and I'm nervous to see them.
La apoyo. Muy bien.
I care a lot about them, and I care about the way they perceive me, because Evelyn has made it very clear that I have to impress her family if I have any chance at being married to her.
¿Qué tal viaje? Yo estoy rojo. ¿Ya? Rojo, la sol.
Yeah, he was asking how was your trip.
Oh, my trip. Bien, super largo.
¿Ya no piensas ir a Estados Unidos?
Sí, yo vivo aquí siempre, todo el tiempo.
Wow. ¿Qué es lo que tú piensas? ¿Casarte con ella?
I'm wondering what are your plans and if you're planning on marrying me.
¿Cuál es la plan? Pero el problema es...
Evelyn.
Sí.
Hola, I am really nervous that Evelyn will say no to my proposal, but I think me being here and, you know, showing her that I'm able to interact with her family and speak Spanish, that will prove to her that I'm ready to make a life here.
Look how cute this cake is.
You got it. Careful.
I come from a really, really close family. I want Cory to start connecting with my family better so they can know him as an individual, not just Evelyn's gringo boyfriend.
Can we do magic tricks?
Yeah. Chicos, chicos, ¿quieren venir a ver un truco de magia?
No.
Ven.
Ay, ay, ay. Wow.
Magic has always been something I've been into as a kid. I've always found it entertaining, and I just thought it would be a good opportunity for me to help immerse myself in her family.
So, what do they say for welcome?
Bienvenidos.
Bienvenidos. I'd like to do some magic tricks. No, it's not.
Fine.
Okay, take the card. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Fine, I won't look.
Okay. Take those cards.
Enséñale la carta a los otros si tú quieres. Yo no las voy a ver.
I want you to write down the card. After he writes it on there, I want him to fold the paper.
Yeah, he's ready, Cory.
All right, now everybody, this, I'm gonna have to light it on fire. So I don't know where I can do that. And I'm gonna use the ashes to determine what the card is. Okay, what we're gonna do over here. Here we go.
¿Le estás viendo, Philip?
Everybody focus.
Todo el mundo enfoque su energía en la carta.
Yeah.
Okay, mira.
Siete de diamonds?
Sí lo viste. El siete de brillos. De la ceniza salió. ¿Usted qué piensa? ¿Hay magia o no hay magia?
Magia negra.
Saying that you're working with black magic or something.
Se mantiene algo raro. Tal vez Cory tiene algún trato medio raro, quizás diabólico, no sé.
No, but tell them no, it's just regular. Está regular, normal, no, it's not está black magic, no.
No. I am not getting the same reactions that I'm used to.
La fuego.
Y sí, me pareció raro por lo que cuando me ahorita me enseñó que estaba sella quemado, estaba el número 7. Tú no me trabajas así, sino que estás trabajando con la magia negra, pues.
I think I may have possibly offended Abuela or just scared her, I'm not sure. The whole point of doing the magic tricks was just to impress Evelyn's family so that I could be more connected with them, but it just totally backfired. I really didn't think it would go so badly.
Step, you already clear that you already have. Now we need to know
the process.
Yeah, the processes.
I'm really excited to finally get some information on the process of getting married in India. So I'm going to go see an immigration lawyer with Sumit.
Sumit.
Hi, Jenny.
We're one step closer to marriage at this point, and it means that he's serious about me, really does love me, and does intend to marry me.
Nice to meet you. Thank you for seeing us today.
As Jenny's foreigner, marriage law in India, it's more complicated. Getting married here is not as easy as Jenny thinks.
Basically, we just want to discuss, like, what we need to do in order to get married.
You need to apply for the marriage under the Special Marriage Act.
Special Marriage Act. Yeah.
And for that, you need to send the notice to the registrar.
All right.
Then he will further issue the notice to dwelling place, notice board of the registrar office, permanent address place.
Why are they gonna send a notice at my permanent address?
Because the law provides that.
That notice is gonna go to his permanent address, and well, that means it's gonna go to his parents.
Because in a normal circumstance, right? The marriage is to be solemnized with the consent of all the parties.
Okay.
Right. Take for example, you have a wife staying at your permanent place. She might not be knowing it. And how that will be unearthed?
That's true.
That's where.
We didn't expect that this will gonna happen, because sending a notice to my parents' house that we are getting married makes me scared, because if they find out, everything gonna get ruined. They were the worst thing I ever heard.
Can they object simply because they don't want us to marry?
Nobody can hold them to raise any objection, right?
Mm-hmm.
But whether that will be upheld or not, that's depending upon law. Then you have the recourse to the court.
We have to start fighting and start going to courts, and we have to hire lawyers. How much is this going to end up costing? Is it going to get costly for us to fight?
I can say they are not very cheap.
Okay.
That was absolutely the worst news that we could have heard. I felt sick to my stomach. I felt my heart drop, and it just sat in my stomach, and I felt like I could have been sick at any moment. Sumit was definitely feeling the same. I think we were both just shocked.
I hope things are clear.
Yeah, things are clear.
Yes, things are clear.
So when Sumit's parents get the notice, I'm pretty sure that they're gonna come storming to our apartment to ask their son, what the hell are you doing?
What are we gonna do now?
We're gonna do nothing.
What? Well, I have nothing to go back to, and if I have to leave you...
You don't need me.
I don't want to go back to you.
Who can maintain a long-distance relationship for 6 years? Who? It's almost impossible, but we did it. So here I come. We're gonna get married. We're gonna be together. We love each other, and then, oh, what a blow. What a blow we just suffered right now.
People need to understand. Everybody need to understand why. We love each other. Nobody can keep us apart. Whatever I need to do, we'll do.